Hello students, today we are going to start our fifth unit of plus two biology, that is ecology. Ecology is the fifth unit of biology. Okay, in this unit we are going to study about the interaction between the abiotic and biotic factors, how they both are interacting each other, how they are going to affect each other. When talk about this unit, we are going to study level of organization, that is level of organization. So what is level of organization? We have studied level of organization in our previous classes also, like first micromolecules and macromolecules, micro and macromolecules, they aggregated and they form cell. Cell formed tissue. Tissue formed organ. Organ form organ system, and then this organ system developed into organisms. So this we have discussed. First, micro and macromolecules, they aggregated to form cell. Then the similar cells, they aggregated to form tissue. That tissues form the organisms, and then organization of systems, then organism, individual or organisms. Now this is lower organization, lower level of organization. This is lower level of organization. In ecology, we are going to study higher level of organization. Higher level of organization, how we can say that from organisms, now in this we are going to study formation of population. Then after population, what we are going to establish, that is the ecosystem. And then after ecosystem, we are going to study the biomes. So in this level of organization, we are going to study organisms, population, ecosystem and biomes on later on. Okay, now in the first chapter, as I have written here, in the first chapter we will discuss some of the terms and the relationship between the organism and the population. We are going to study various terms related to organisms and population and biotic and abiotic factors. So abiotic factor, when we talk about abiotic factors, when we talk about, then what are the abiotic factors? Like water, then soil, air, water, air, soil, light and temperature. So water, soil, air, light and temperature. So temperature, So in this chapter, there will be terms related to water, how means earth covered with water, what is usable water, gravitational force, and about soil profile. We will study in depth. We will study this in air. Various strata are formed in air atmosphere. We are going to study the composition of air. We will study then the light, how it affects light, and various strata according to light in pond area, and then the temperature and the adaptation of the plants and animals which are related to these factors we will study. And beyond this, we are going to study the abiotic factors as well. Biotic factors is biotic factors. When we'll talk about biotic factors, means how the population is related to each other. Means we are going to study some of the terms like the symbiotic association. Then after symbiotic association, we are going to study parasitism, pathogens, then we can study about the competition. The competition can be between a similar species and different species also, how they are going to compete in this environment for their food, for shelter, for breeding. These types of interactions, symbiotic, parasitism, pathogens, and competitions. So these types of terms we'll going to discuss in this chapter. So first of all, when you are starting, going to start this chapter, we'll study about some of the related terms. Like first, the most important term we are going to study is, the first term is habitat. Now, what is habitat? The place of living of an organism is called its habitat. So the place where the organism live, the place where the organisms live is called habitat. Like we can talk about the natural habitat, like lions, they used to live in forest. That is their natural habitat, not in zoo. So our habitat, where we are living, this is our natural habitat. So we can define the habitat where the organism live. That is simple term. Next important terms is environment. Now environment we are going to study is can be defined as the aggregate of all the external condition and influences affecting the life and development of an organism in its natural habitat. So all the factors which we deal day to day from our birth till death, they are all our environment. Or you can say, you as an individual, all except you is your environment. There can be biotic factor and it can be abiotic factors. So we can say, what is environment? It is an aggregate of all external conditions that influence life and development So again, what is environment? Environment is aggregate of all the external condition that influence life and its development. So in this environment we are having three component. So in our environment we are having three component. First component is atmosphere. The second component is hydrosphere. And the third component is lithosphere. Again, the first component is atmosphere, second is hydrosphere, and the third one is lithosphere. So these are the component of our environment. This term ecology, some of the important question which can be asked, that is ecology, was given by Ernst Haeckel. In 1869, he coined the term ecology. The term refers to the study of interrelationship between the living organisms and their physical and biological environment. Okay, now atmosphere, beta, hydrosphere, and lithosphere. Now, you know what is level of organization. So in next video, we'll study about the level of organization.